Barat Hashem, we're going to start Daf Tet. The Gemara says, Mishnah, Mi shelo hag biyom tov harishon shel hag. Someone who didn't bring the Korban Hagiga. Rashi, Mi shelo hag, shelo evi hagigato biyom harishon shel hag. Again, Mishnah, Mi shelo hag biyom tov harishon shel hag, hogeg et kol haregel. He could celebrate, he could bring his Hagigah throughout the whole holiday. The Yom Tova Haron Shel Hag, and being the Hag is Sukkot, he could even bring it on Shmini Atzeret. Rashi, the Yom Tova Haron Shel Hag, Hogeg, Shmini Atzeret. Rafagav Deregel Befne Atzmo Hu, even though we say Shmini Atzeret is its own holiday, Have Tashlumin Larishon, it's considered a Tashlumin for the first one, for the first beginning of the holiday. Avar haregel velo hag. If he passed through the whole holiday and shmini atzeret and he didn't bring his korban hagiga, eno hayav v'achariyuto. You don't have to bring it again. You don't have to pay it. You don't owe it. Ve'al zeh ne'emar about this it says me'uvat, something that's crooked, lo yuchal litkon, that you cannot straighten out. Ve'hisaron, and something that's missing, lo yuchal imanot, that you can't count it again. Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya omer, ezeh me'uvat she'en yachol lehitaken. What's something crooked that you cannot fix? Zeh abala irva. This is someone who was with a irva, ve'olid mimena mamzer, and he created a mamzer. Why only that? Im tomar begonev vechozel, if you say that he stole, yachol ula haziro v'yitaken, you can give it back, lav ani tak la'ase, and do it. But what are you going to do with the mamzer? The mamzer is always there. Rashi says, ve'olid mamzer shehevi pisulim b'Yisrael. He brought pisulim among the Jewish people. V'yehe zikaron, it's a remembrance, la'avono, for his sin. Lefikach, therefore, and avonotav nimhakim b'teshuvah. His sin is not fully erased with the teshuvah.
I thought it was for eshetish
mamzer. Mamzer is ani chayve kiritut. We'll see. Gemara says, if he stole yachola haziro, temegiven ato v'gezer ato lebe'alim v'yitaken, v'yehe metukan menachet. Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai omer, no, I have a different take. And korim mi'uvat, in order to be crooked, ela lemisha ya metukan techila. I only say you're crooked if you were straight first. Right? I only consider you crooked if you were straight first. And therefore, we started early, now you're late. You're on time. We started a couple minutes ago. We finished very early today. We were just bored. Right? Right? So Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says, I only call it crooked if it was straight first. So what's crooked? Right? Ve'ezehu, ze tamid chacham aporesh min haTorah. Tamid chacham who is learning Torah and stop. That's me'uvat lo yachol etkon. He can't fix it. Rashi me'uvat mekukal. Again. Read it again. Mishelo hag biyom tov harishon. If someone didn't bring his hagigah on the first day of Yom Tov shel hag, hogeget kol haregel, he could bring it during the whole holiday. And on Sukkot Yom Tov acharon shel hag, even though it's a separate holiday. Avar haregel velo hag, if the whole holiday passed, then he didn't bring the hagigah, eno hayav b'achariyutoy. He's not responsible to bring a replacement. Al zeh ne'emar, about such a thing it says, me'uvat, something crooked, lo yochal litkon, that you can't fix. V'chisaron, it's something missing. Lo yuchal imanot, that you can't bring back. Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya omer, no, ezeh me'uvat she'en yechol etkon. What's something crooked that you can't fix? Zeh abal ha'irva, someone that slept with a forbidden woman, ve'olid mimena mamzer, and he fathered a mamzer. Why do I say that? Im tomar begonevi gozel, that's crooked. Yachol ola haziru, I can give back v'yitaken, but the mamzer I can't take away. Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai omer, en korim mi'uvat, in order to say crooked, ela lemi she'ya metukan betchila, only something that was fixed. What's fixed? Ve'netavet, and then it got crooked. Ve'ezeh, tamid chacham aporesh min haTorah. That's a tamid chacham who separates from the Torah. Tosafot says, ze'abala irva. He doesn't want to say like Rashi. Rashi says you can't get a kapara. He doesn't say that. But he says, the tve boshtonika. His shame is greater. Meaning, a guy that does teshuvah, so the avera is not there every day, staring him in the face. He doesn't have to live with the consequences. He did teshuvah, Hashem forgave him, shalom yisrael. Right? But if there's a mamzer, nerei la'olam. Aval she'ar averot, rotzeach v'gazlan, en edav lefanav. There's no testimony that he did it. Minan Emili says the Gemara, how do I know that there's Tashlumin, not only on the holiday, but also on Shmini Atzeret? Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Rashi. Minan Emili, the Yom Tov Aharon Shel Chag HaSukkot, Tashlumin LeKorbanot HaChag LeYechidim, that they can make him up for an individual. Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Mishum Rabbi Yishmael. Ne'emar Atzeret B'Shvi'i Shel Pesach. Ve'ne'emar Atzeret B'Shmini Shel Chag. Sheshet yamim tochal matzot, oviyom eshivii atzeret la'adonai Elohecha. And it says, Shivat yamim takribu yishe la'ashem, v'yom ha'shemini mikra kodesh yeh lachem, v'kraftem yishe la'ashem, atzereti. So both of them are called atzeret, the seventh and the eighth. Ma lehalan, just like on Shivii shel Pesach. We know l'tashlumin, that you can make up the korban even on the seventh day. Af kan l'tashlumin. So to oviyom shemini atzeret, you can make tashlumin, Rashi. Atzeret b'shvi'i shel Pesach b'parasha kol ha'bechor shesh yamim tochal matzot v'yom atzeret. Ma l'shvi'i shel Pesach tashlumim l'rishon, it's a makeup for the first day. Shehare eno haluk mishe lefanav. It's not different than the rest of the holiday. It's all one holiday. Shemini atzeret haluk mishe lefanav. But shemini atzeret is different. L'nyam pazar kashav. Has its own pious, has its own zman. And the main thing is the korban that we see in the Torah is different. Right? Mal lehalan letashlumin, afkan letashlumin, says Gemara mufne. We have gezerot shavot. Some are open-ended, meaning the pasuk that we're using as the anchors on the two sides are open. I'm not using them for other dirashot. And then sometimes I do use one at least for other dirashot. So the Gemara qualifies this, mufne. This gezerah shavah, both words have to be open. The ilav mufne, if the words on both sides are not open, ika lemifrach, ma leshivah, because the rule is like this, when the gezerah shavah words are open, so then they're clearly coming only for the gezerah shavah, and then I can't ask questions. It's like the Torah wrote openly a halakha. When the Torah writes a halakha openly, there's no questions to ask. But when we're using the midot shatorah nedreshet bahem, like kal vachomer, for example, kal vachomer, you ask a question. The kal vachomer is not a kal vachomer. When you have a mamatzinu, right? When you have a binyan av, that the Torah said something in one place, and we apply it to other places. If we have a difference, if we ask a question, oh, this is like this, and this is different like that, then maybe you can't bring from one over to the other. A kal vachomer, a gezerah shavah depends on how it's structured. If it's not mufne on both sides, or at least on one side, depending on which opinion. If it's not mufne, then I could ask a question. And I could sort of untether it or disprove it. Whereas if it's open on both sides, or at least on one side, then that word, which is not being the drash for anything else, serves as the source of the drasha. And you can't ask on a drasha befirush. So we say mufne, it's open. The ilav mufne, ikal mifrach. I'd have a question and I'd knock out the gezerah shavah. Ma l'shvi'i shel Pesach sheken eno haluk shel milefanav. Shvi'i shel Pesach is not different. It's part of the same holiday. Tomar b'shmini shel chag shehaluk mishelefanav. That it's different, like we said, l'inyan pazar kashav, those differences. Says Gemara, lai means yes. Or be'emet, afnu ye mufne. It is open. Let's see, Rashi, mufne. V'tzricha gezera shava sheteh mufne, has to be open. D'tu lo parchinan ale midi. We don't ask any questions. The kol gezera shava mufne, when the gezera shava is open, lemedim, we learn the gezera shava ve'em eshivim, and you can't ask questions on it. Last says, lai be'emet, it is mufne. Why? How do I know? Mechti. My atzeret. What does atzeret come to teach me? Atzur ba'asiyat melacha. That you have to hold back. Atzur means to stop, right? Like atzur, held back. Ba'asiyat melacha, not to work on the holiday. On both of them, ha'ketiv lo ta'asim melacha. It says don't do work. Ready, said, ba'yom ha'shivi'i, עצרת לא תעשה מלאכה, וביום השמיני עצר יהיה לכם, כל מלאכת עבודה לא תעשו. So עצרת is coming to say that you can't do work. The Torah specifies that I can't do work. If that's the case, the עצרת word is extra. Right? עצרת דכתב רחמנה למה לי, אלא שמה מינה להפנויה. It's to be open, Rashi. הכתיב לא תעשה מלאכה באוקטרה גופה, ביום השביעי עצרת להשם אלוהיך לא תעשה מלאכה. So therefore, it's mufni. Vitana, we have a braita. Whose limud was that? That was Rabbi Yohanan saying in the name of Rabbi Ishmael. Vitana, but a braita, mighty le mehacha. They learn it from here. Look in Rashi. Vitana, mighty le mehacha. Mishum de Rabbi Yohanan de gamar la kedamrin al el. Emorahi, he's an emora. Nakat. Hacha Hailishna, they said over here, Titania, the Hagotem Oto, Hagla Hashem Shabbat Yamim, you should celebrate it, a Hagigat Hashem. 7 days, Yachol Yeh Hogeg Volech Kol Shema. I might say every day you have to bring a Hagigah. Talmud Lomar, Rashi, Kol Shema Kol Yom Vayom, Talmud Lomar Oto, the Hagotem Oto, one. Oto ata hogeg, vi ata hogeg kol shiva. You only have to bring one. Rashi, Talmud lomar oto, besefe dekrat, tre oto ketiv. It says it twice. Why is Rashi not happy with the first one? Tahogu oto.
Because it says twice, you need to only bring it once?
No, because it says Oto twice. But why does Rashi want Oto twice? What's the matter with Oto once? Maybe the first one, even though it says the Hagotem Oto, could be Shivat Yamim, 7 days. Oto, second time, only one time. Well, you think so? I don't know, let's see. Talmud lomar oto. Oto ata hogeg vi ata hogeg kol shiva. Im ken, lama ne'emar shiva. So why does it say 7? L'teshlumin. That if you didn't bring it on the first day, you could continue. Uminayin. And how do I know? Shem lo hag yom tov harishon shel hag. Shehogeg v'olech et kol haregel v'yom tov ha'acharon. Hare, 7 days would be the 7 days of Sukkot, and not Shemini Atzeret. Talmud lomar, b'chodesh ha-shivi'i, tahogu oto. Right? In the 7th month, you should celebrate. Right? What's b'chodesh ha-shivi'i? I know when Sukkot is. We've been talking about it for a couple of pisukim. So why does it say in the 7th month? Right? בחודש השביעי תחוגו אותו. אי בחודש השביעי יאכל יהא חוגג והולך כל החודש כולו. You missed שמיני עצרת? Keep going. תלמוד לומר אותו. That's the second one. You're right. אותו אתה חוגג. On holiday you can be חוגג. וי אתה חוגג חוצה לו. But you can't go outside of it. So it's the pasuk that says Bahodesh Shivi'i Tahogu Oto, celebrate, bring the Hagigah in the 7th month, clearly is coming to include something on top of the 7 days. But from the fact that it says Oto, that addition is limited to the holiday itself. So the first Oto is coming to say only one. The second Oto is coming to limit the new inclusion to only part of the holiday. No, to the 8th day. Umay, that's it. Umay Tashlumin. When we say that it's Tashlumin, what do we mean? Rabbi Yohanan Amar Tashlumin Larishon. All 7 days are coming to make up the first day, meaning that if the main obligation that you have is to bring a korban on the first day. If you miss the first day, you make up during the 7th. Rabbi Hoshaya Amar, Tashlumin Ze Laze. Each day is a Tashlumin for the next day. Meaning, each day really has a chiyuv on its own, but in the end you only have to bring one. My Benayu, what's the difference between the two positions? Amar Bizera, we had this in the beginning of the Masechet. Chiger biyom rishon, v'netpashet biyom sheni, kabinayu. If he was lame on the first day in Patur, and he became healthy on the second day. Rabbi Yochanan amar tashlumim larishon. Rabbi Yochanan says they all make ups for the first day. Kivan de lohazi barishon, since he wasn't eligible on the first day. Lohazi. So you miss the chiyuv time. You don't have to make anything up. Rabbi Yoshaya amar tashlumim zelaze. Each one is a makeup for the next day, meaning each one has its own chiyuv. But you only have to bring it once. So even though I missed the first day, the chiyuv reasserts itself on the second day.
I'm still using lashon tashlumim, no?
Right. Agreed. Rashi. Kulan tashlumim larishon. They all make up for the first day. Share yom echad asa katuv ikar bechulan. The first day, the pasuk made it in ikar. Dichtiv, like it says, oto. V'shel aharav asa tashlumin lo. And the pasuk after, you made it a tashlumin. Oto, the first oto says the first day is the main one. After that is all making up for the first one. Rabbi Hoshaya says, kulan tashlumim ze laze. En lecha yom bahem, shen chovato tiluya bo be'atzmo, lemi shelo נראה או שלא הקריב בימים הראשונים. דיום ראשון שהוא נראה להביא עיקר לדידה וימים שלאחריו תשלומים לו. Meaning, the first day that he could bring, that's enough for him. And every day after that is a make-up for the first day that he could have brought it. So according to Rabbi Yochanan, the chiyuv starts on the first day only. And if you didn't get a chiyuv on the first day, it never comes on you. Whereas according to Rabbi Hoshaya, the chiyuv could come any day of the holiday. Which day does it come for, Jimmy? The first day that you're eligible. So kulam tashlumim zilazeh means that the first day that you come is your ikar, and every day after that is a tashlumim. Whereas going to Rabbi Yochanan, you can only start that train on the first day.
Chiger eno ra'ui lira'ot kedamrina b'matniti.
Chiger doesn't have to go. So if he was chiger on the first day, he was patur. According to Rabbi Yochanan, the chiyuv never comes on him. According to Rabbi Hoshaya, the chiyuv comes later.
How do we match this up with the
machloket in the Mishnah?
Does it match up with the
machloket
in the Mishnah?
What does tashlumin with the first one?
This is
the machloket.
This is
Gemara.
What's the first word
on the
word?
I'm
lost.
We're going to start now.
What page?
Ted. Okay. The first one line is Bashini. It's five lines from the bottom. Umi Amar Rabbi Yochanan Hachi. Did Rabbi Yochanan say this point that only the first day is the chiyuv, and after that, it's what's it called? You're not. It's only a tashlumin for the first day. Veha Amar Chizkia. Chizkia says, Nitma Bayom Mevi. Balayla Enu Mevi. Chizkia said,
no wonder, Rabbi.
It's there. You just got to open the back. Oh.
Somebody give it to him. You give it to you open.
You thought you were losing it, right?
Thank you, Rabbi.
Have
it to everybody. No
worries. Okay. Chizkia. Nitma bayom. If he became Tameh on the first day of Sukkot, Mevi, he brings it. Balayla, if he became Tameh the night before, Eno Mevi, he doesn't bring it. Why? Because you can't bring the Korban at night. So if you became Tameh at night, right, if you became Tameh at night, the chiyuv of bringing the Korban never came on you. Whereas if you became Tameh, let's say you prayed Vatikin, And right after the Amidah, you became Tamim. You're right. But for a few seconds over there, you were good. So the Hayuv hit you over there. Right? Look at Rashi. Nitma bayom bekritut tenan. Nazir mevi korban echad al tumot arbe. A nazir sometimes can bring a lot of korbanot for one tumah. Right? We know that if a nazir becomes tameh, he has to bring a korban al shetimen edro, and then he shaves bald, right? And starts again. Ve'amar Chizkiya nitma biyom het. If he became tameh on the eighth day, shehura ui lavi korbanot, that he already could have brought his korban, ulatchil minyan eziruto, v'yamim shemana kodem tuma betelim, the days before fall off, kemo shenemar v'yom eshemini yavi shedet torim ve'ezir la'ashem kol yemen ezro v'yamim arishonim yipelu kitemen ezro. So then mevi korban ala tuma sheni. So the guy became Tameh. And he went to the Kohen and he admitted he became Tameh. And the Kohen told him, okay, here's what you do. Come back on the seventh day and bring these korbanot. On his way to the Beit HaMikdash. Boom. Again. So, since he was already eligible to bring the korban, he's going to have to bring, on the next eighth day, two sets. Right? Shekvar netchayev bekorban atuma, veetchila shniya. The second one started. Vare ze. Vare zu tuma aheret. So this is a new tuma. Aval netma belil shemini became tameh the night before. Eno mevi ela korban echad. He only has to bring one korban at the next round. Delo yatzah mituma rishona. He never went out of his original tumah to a time that he could have brought a korban. So therefore, it's all called one long tumah. No, if he became tameh, when, if they're all like one tumah. So meaning, you're a nazir, Jimmy. You forgot. You went to some funeral, right? Ah, or whatever. You went and you're going to stay in the Kohanim room and then you whatever, right? Ah, no. Whatever you did wrong. So now you're tameh, right? Chayav among korban. This is what Rashi says is only if before you became tahor,
you had nothing to cover.
They sprinkled on you. If they didn't sprinkle on you, you went to the next thing. You're not allowed to go again. But you did one korban anyway. Once you became eligible, even though you didn't finish the process, since you're eligible, you have to bring another korban. So, yes, korban echad of tumot arbe. You got your tahor and you're ready to bring a korban. Right? So the question is, at what point does it make a difference? The night before, I'm tahor. But I can't bring a korban yet. So that's what Chizkiya says. Even though I'm tahor, since I can't bring a korban, we don't say that you're ready.
You're still tameh?
You're not tameh. But you're not ready to start the new nezirut. Because you weren't ready to bring. Once you were able to bring the first korban, it's like it's in the kitty. Now anything else is going to need a new korban. Question is, the night before, I'm ready to bring the korban, but the Beit HaMikdash is closed. So what does that count as? Chizki says Beit HaMikdash is closed means not ra'oi for a korban. You're not allowed to bring a korban at night, right? But Rabbi Yochanan Amar Rashi ho'il v'tava l'tumato rishona. Once he went to the mikveh on the seventh day, the he'ariv shimsho, and it became nighttime. I could eat tiruma now, right? Yeah. V'he'ariv shimsho nitchayev bekorban ve'af al pi she'en laila ra'ui lekorban. Even though at night you cannot bring a korban, alma yisi af al gav de'lo ra'ui lekorban. Even though he's not eligible for a korban, yesh lo tashlumin. He has to make up. Meaning it already goes. Now I need to make it up when I bring it. Says the Gemara. No, it's not because he holds. It's not because he holds that you could get a chiyuv even though you weren't ra'ui. That's what it seems like. It seems like Rabbi Yochanan is saying. It seems like Rabbi Yochanan is saying that if even though the chiyuv hit you when you weren't eligible at night, it could still hit. So too, let's say that the chiyuv could hit you on the first day, even though he was a chiger. What's the difference between this guy that became tahor at night when he can't bring a korban, or the chiger that can't bring the korban in the day? Let the chiyuv hit him the same. Says the Gemara. Amar Rabbi Yirmiya, Shani Tuma Diyesh Lo Atashlumin BePesach Sheni. No. Pesach Tuma is not so, doesn't push off Chiyuvim so much. You know how I know that? You can't convert Tuma to Chiger. Tuma, guy that's Tameh, he's somewhat in the parasha of the Korban. You know the proof? Because the guy that's Tameh on Pesach Rishon has to bring a Korban on Pesach Sheni. You see the Chiyuv hit him, but he just makes it up. Rashi. Shani Tuma, Korban on Etchem Mepene Tuma is different. Ulefikach yesh lo tashlumim, v'avagav delo nerei lav. Even though I can't bring it, why? Hoyil v'yesh la tashlumim, kegon. Ilu netma bePesach Rishon, mevi bePesach Sheni. Sharei mi shelo nerei berishon yesh lo tashlumim. Aval anitchem mepene davar acher. Someone that couldn't bring the korban for other reasons. Lo matzinu lo tashlumim elam kenderei lavi. So therefore, Higer doesn't get to bring it. Says the Gemara, Amar of Leira Papa, Matkif Leira Papa. So the Papa asked Reb Yirmiya, Hani Hadet Good Lemande Amar Pesach Sheni Tashlumin the Rishon. The one that says that it's a makeup for the first one. According to the one that says it's its own holiday, meaning that the chiyuv comes on independently of whatever was there before. Rashi in Pesachim says, "V'it lechiyuv ha'be'am penavshe v'afilu leman de'lo et chaze berishon." Even someone that wasn't ahoy on the first day would have to bring it. So Rashi says here, "V'achshav en lechalit lo ta'amosher b'yochanan b'hoyu v'yesh letumat tashlumim l'shini." According to that opinion, the reason why he's bringing Pesach Sheni is not because the chiyuv hit him, even though he was tameh on Pesach Rishon. It's a new chiyuv that comes for people that weren't yotzei the first one. My ikala meimar, ela amar of papa, kasava Rabbi Yochanan, laila enu mechusar zman. Rabbi Yochanan holds that the night time doesn't mean that you didn't get to a time that you could bring a korban. You could bring the korban. It's like the Beit HaMikdash didn't open. Your kohen didn't come, but the chiyuv hit you already. It's a technicality. There's two ways to look at the night before the eighth day. One way to look at it is, listen, since I can't bring the Korban till the morning, the time of the Korban didn't come. The other way to look at it is, technically the time of the Tumah is here. The only thing is, I'm not allowed to bring a korban at night, but I'm ra'ui to bring a korban. Happens. I'm ra'ui.
Yeah, we can argue about it back and forth.
Right. I'm ra'ui. Technical problem. I can't bring one in.
It's a technical problem.
It's a technical problem.
All right. If we fix the technical problem, we open the place, we'll bring the coin. Can you bring it? No.
If it was day now, could I bring it? Yeah. So.
It's a different thing. Okay, it's not in your hand, yeah. Technical problem, something you can fix in your hand.
Jack. I understand that there's a section that you do want to look. But there's also this way that night is not, I'm not ra'ui. If Hashem would make sunrise right now, it'd be Raui.
Ah, that's Mahanes. You like that? Something make Nes.
Not so mech on the Nes. I'm just saying if.
We don't work with
Rashi. Kasavar of Yohanan. Now Jack is telling me the rules.
Kasavar
of Yohanan. En chisaron zman. Pemi shehigia. Lelo lehikare. I know he must have woken up on the right side of the bed. He's still on fire.
I've been with you every day for 3 years.
Don't blame it on me, Baba. En chisaron. En chisaron zman. Bimi shehigia lelo lehakriv korbenotav maha. The fact that it's nighttime, it doesn't say that it's like I'm still missing time for someone who could bring the korbanot tomorrow. Hilkach mechuyavu bekorban. Right now, I'm chayav in the korban. Ela shalayla me'akevo. The night is holding him back. Milavi. Aval chiger biyom rishon. A guy that's lame on the first day. En alav shum chovat re'ia. He has no obligation. Lefikach. En alav teshlumin. There's no makeup for him. Says Gemara. Umi amar Rabbi Yochanan hachi. Does Rabbi Yochanan hold that the nighttime is considered a sha'ar re'uya? V'ha'amar Rabbi Yochanan. Didn't Rabbi Yochanan say, Ra'a achat, we have the same type of halakha by Yizav, that sometimes he could bring one korban on many re'iyot. But if he got to the time, sometimes Yizav has to bring a korban, sometimes he doesn't. If he saw two re'iyot, he's Yizav. He needs 7 clean days. But he doesn't bring a korban. We learned in Masechet Megillah. 3 re'iyot, he's a zav, he needs 7 days and a korban. Right? So we say, now, on his after 7 clean days, right, when does that end? At night, the next morning, he's going to bring a korban. We have that same limbo night, right? A limbo night. So now, if he becomes tameh at night,
it happened one more.
If he becomes tameh at night, he doesn't have to bring another korban. He can get away with one korban. If he becomes tameh the next day, he's ra'oi to bring a korban. Now he has to bring next time 2 korbanot, right?
If it happened the next day after the 8th day in the morning, you put the korban ready.
I didn't bring the korban yet. If I brought the korban, of course, I'm finished. So I didn't bring the korban. I could bring the korban. I have to bring 2 next time. If I couldn't bring the korban, I bring one. Let's see inside. Umi amar Rabbi Yochanan. So now it's Rashi. Ra'a had balayla. Look in Rashi. Zav shesafar shiva nekiim kemishpato. He counted 7 clean days. V'taval. He went to the mikvah. V'arif shimsho. Because they used to dip the zav on the 7th day and wait for the night so he could be tahor. V'chazar v'ra'a ahad balayla. Then he saw 1 re'iyah at night. V'shtayim l'mahar, and 2 the next day.
Does that count 2 or 3? That's what you question. So,
let's see. Amar Yochanan, ra'a ahad balayla v'shtayim bayom. So 1 at night, 2 in the day. Mevi. Rashi, mevi. Korban al tumashniya zu levad mina korban shevi al rishona. Why? Because the bulk of his tumah, or to say better, when you see only 1 re'iyah, you're not really a zav yet, you're like a baal keri. You don't become a full zav till you see a second re'iyah. So since he became a zav in the daytime when he's already able to bring the korban, now he has to bring a second korban. V'yavi shne korbanu kishitayir. Ho'il v'ror lo ra'ah ha'sheniyah. Till the time he can bring a korban, yesh lo tashlumin. There's a makeup because he became hayav. The afal hashenia yavi, and you bring for the first one and the second. Afal pishet chilata, even though you started betoch zman korban arishona. Lo amrinan hada tumai. We don't say it's all one big tumah. Upiresh Rav Yosef et atam b'maseche kiritut. Rav Yosef explained the reason. Lefi sha're'iya rishona shel zav ena ela kekeri be'amharet. What about the first one that was at night? Now the first one is keri. Doesn't make you a zav yet. V'chichazi inach lemahar. When he sees the next one tomorrow, mitzarefet ba'adayu. It joins with the tomorrow one, and it's mainly tomorrow. When you see the second one, that makes the first one zav. In the nighttime,
Ki hadar hazi, when he sees the next day, inech lemahar mitzarfinam ba'aday, we combine the first one with the next two tomorrow, and we consider it all to be done tomorrow. Whereas...
this is a proof that counting, not for the before, for the after.
Wait, no, the night counts as before. You see, the night is part of the.
No, but we said if you...
I'm counting the night as before.
Why?
Because, watch, wait. Right? Shtayim ba'layla v'ahad ba'yom, but if he saw two at night and one in the day, he doesn't have to bring a second korban. One korban will be enough. Why? Because when he saw the first two and he became a zav, he was still not in a time that he could bring the korban yet, because it was nighttime. So over here, Rabbi Yochanan is saying, he's saying that the nighttime, since I can't bring the korban yet, is not considered a time that's roif for korban. Whereas by the nazir that became tameh, he said that if he became tameh at night, he still has to bring a second korban. Why? Because the nighttime is already considered the roif for a korban. It's just the Beit HaMikdash is closed. By the nazir, he said, Rabbi Yochanan said, Af balayla nami mevi. If he became tameh at night, he has to bring. Why? How do you couldn't bring the korban yet? The chiyuv never hit you. No, the chiyuv hits you. Why can't I bring it? Beit HaMikdash is closed. Over here, Rabbi Yochanan says, if he saw the second tumah at night, he does never bring a korban. Why? Because the chiyuv never hit you. Why? Because the Beit HaMikdash is closed. So over there, he considers Beit HaMikdash closed. That's just a technicality. Over here, he says Beit HaMikdash is closed. The chiyuv didn't even hit you. So he sotered himself. Must be the reason why Rabbi Yochanan said over there is not because Beit HaMikdash is closed. Must be the reason is because he holds every day is its own Tashlumin. That the chiyuv hits you what? Constantly. Says the Gemara, Ki Amar Rabbi Yochanan. When did Rabbi Yochanan say that if he became tameh two at night, that he doesn't have to bring a korban? LeDivrei Omer Laila Mechusar Zman. He's saying it according to the other opinion. He's explaining the opinion that he doesn't agree with. The one that says that nighttime is Mechusar Zman. We'll say that if you saw two at night, you don't have to bring. Says Gemara. I don't need him to tell me that. Anybody would know that if you say the night time is considered mechusar zman, it's not considered a time that's right for the korban. Of course you're patur. You didn't get to a time that's right for korban. What did Rabbi Yochanan for? Says Gemara, it's tericha. I still need it. Salka daitach amina kaat kafta derav shisha beret derav idi. You might get fooled by Rav Shisha Bered Rav Idi's question, because he said, hey, this one started at night. He saw the first one at night. And therefore, even if I saw two in the day, I should still be patur, because the start was at night, the Ri'iyah Rishonah was at night. Kamash Malan Kedrav Yosef. That meaning, you might say, hey, no matter what, he already started at night. And therefore, even though two were in the day, the night time is still what? So go Kamash Malan, Kedrav Yosef. That since the first one is like a Baal Keri, it doesn't count for anything until the next day.
So make a difference when you see the first one at night or day? I mean, looks like...
No, it doesn't make a difference.
If you see the first one night,
even though you see the first one at night, it's as if you saw it in the day. That's Rabbi Yochanan's Chidush. Look at Rashi. Ma'od etayma ka'at kafta... The Rav Shisha, the Atkif Bekiritut. He asked in Kiritut, Alatam Shenatan Rav Yosef Aladavar, Kemoshi Pirashti Lemala, because it's about Keri. Teda, the Har Iyar, Shonashal Kola Zavim, Keri Be'almahu. Tehihadar Hazi, when he sees the two the next day, Mitzarfin and Behadayu, Hachanami Loshna, Matkif La Rav Shisha, Rav Shisha asked me, Dami, Hatam Kulu Bizman Hiuva Hazinu. Over there, he saw all of them at a time that he'll be Chayav. The next day. But over here, he saw one before, maybe not. Kamash Malan, no. Amalei, Avar HaRegev Lohag, if the holiday passed and he didn't bring his korban, Eno Chaya Bachariyuto, he doesn't have to make it up.
ועל זה נאמר בהצד שתינג, we say, מעוות, something crooked, לא יוכל לתקון, that can't be fixed. וחיסרון and something missing, לא יוכל להימנות, that can't be counted. אמר לי, בר היי היי להלל. בר היי היי told הלל. תוספות says, תוספות says, יש מפרשים שגר היה. He was a ger. And gerim, we say, are ben Avraham Avinu. והיינו בן אברהם ושרה, שנתוסף היי בשמן. וכן, בג בג, דקולה גמרא, בג, אז עולה היי, so he was also a ger. Okay. So בר היי היי told הלל, היי להימנות, why does it say חיסרון, something missing? לא יוכל להימנות, that you can't count. It should say חיסרון, something missing, לא יוכל להימנות, that can't be filled in. Because if something is missing, you fill it in. You don't count it.
Depends what.
היי להימלות מבעלה, look in Rashi. להימלות מבעלה, אלא אצל חיסרון נופל לשון מילוי. By חיסרון, the proper term is מילוי, fill up. שחסר מצווה אחת, the מצווה he missed, לא יתמלא עוד, won't be filled. חיסרון זה, this missing, שחסר once it was missing. אז גמרא, אלא, זה שמינו חבריו, או שנמנו חבריו לדבר מצווה. His friends, they joined together, and they invited him to do the mitzvah. והוא לא נמנע עמהם, and he didn't go. רשי, שמינו חבריו לדבר מצווה, שאמרו לו בוא עמנו, ולא הלך. נמצא שחסר עצמו מאותו מניין. לא יוכל להימנות עוד באותו מניין. That mitzvah, he won't be able to join. שכבר עשו את המצווה, they already do the mitzvah. They did the mitzvah. אמר לי בר היי היי להלל. בר היי היי told הלל, מי דכתי ושבתם וראיתם. You'll go back and you'll see בין צדיק לרשע. You'll see the difference between the צדיק and the רשע. בין עובד אלוהים, between the one that served Hashem, לאשר לא עבדו, between and the one that didn't serve him. היינו צדיק, היינו רשע, היינו עובד אלוהים. Sorry, my mistake. היינו צדיק, היינו עובד אלוהים. הצדיק is an עובד אלוהים. היינו רשע, היינו אשר לא עבדו. The רשע is the one that didn't serve him. So what do you have to repeat yourself? אמר לי, he says no. צדיק and רשע, like you understand. עובד אלוהים, לאשר עבדו ולא עבדו, תרוויו צדיקי גמורי נינו. לעבדו אין לא עבדו הצדיקים. So why is he called the לא עבדו? ואינו דומה שונה פרקו מאה פעמים, לא שונה פרקו מאה ואחד. The עבדו reviewed his learning 101 times. The לא עבדו reviewed it 100 times.
We do the ones, it's good.
אמר לי, ומשום חד זמנה קרי לי לא עבדו, because he's missing one time, he's called לא עבדו. אמר לאין, he says, yeah, צא ולמד משוק של חמרים. Go learn from the market of the donkey drivers. עשרה פרסה בזוזה. 10 פרסה, 1 זוזה. That's the price. 11 פרסה בתרי זוזה. You need 11, already 2. Not 1.1.
One pallet in the box, paying 2 pallets.
Rashi.
First 2 hours, $10. After that, $40.
Parking him in hand. Sheminu chavir, sorry. Hainu tzadik, hainu obed Elohim. Miu tzadik, umiu obed Elohim. Halo ehadu. Eno dome shone perko. Afa pi sheshnem tzadikim. Lo avadu b'shave. They didn't serve him the same. Sheze abado yoter. Asara parsea. Parsea yaskil lecha adam hamoro bezuz ehad. Shekvar nagu ken. That's like the standard contract. Vim tomar. לא ללך, had an odometer on the חמור, והם תאמר לו, ללך פרסה יתרה. He tell him, I want to go another פרסה. ישאלך שני זוזים. He asks you for another one. אמר לי, now you want to know who בר היי היי was. אמר לי אליהו לבר היי היי. אליהו הנביא told בר היי היי. ואמר לי לרבי אלעזר, מי דכתיב הנה סירבתיך, ולא בכסף. I refine you, but not with silver. בחרתיך, I chose you, Bikur Oni, in the refining furnace of poverty. Melamed teaches, Shehazara Kadosh Baruch Hu Kol Midot Tovot Liten LiYisrael. Hashem looked at all the good midot to give the Jewish people. V'lo Matza Ela Aniyut. The one that he found that would help them most was poverty. Rashi. Tzirachticha v'lo b'chesef. Lo b'esh. Not with fire. Kemo she'tzurfin. Lo b'kesef, meaning not along with silver in fire. Lo b'esh. Kemo she'tzurfim ha'kesef b'esh. Ela b'harticha. B'harti lach. I chose for you kur oni. The refining process of poverty, the tzorfo bo, to refine you with. Kur, the kur hu aheres, that's the clay she tzorfim bo. Says the Gemara, Hainu de Amri, Amar Shmuel, the Temer of Yosef, Hainu de Amri Inchi, that's what people say. Ya'e aniyut al Yehuda'e. Poverty is befitting the Jews. Ki barzasumcha lesusa hivra. Like a red strap for a white horse.
Control the person, Daniyut.
Looks good, Rashi. That Tosfot says, Ki barzasumka, ritzua. Barza is a ritzua. Vdomelom ikara, mashcha, vahashta, avarza. Ubebereshit rabayesh, yae aniyuta le bartedi Yaakov. Poverty is nice for the daughter of Jacob. Ki akar arkata sumka lesus yachivra. Same idea.
It doesn't look like, I mean, the Jews, not compared to other world, not anim.
Reading the one. Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya Omer, Ezehu me'uvat, lo yuch. Hekshah Ravi Yun Yaakov. It says, "Kashe aniyu b'toch beto shel adam yoter mechamishim makot." V'nireh li kashe b'shvil olam hazeh, aval b'shvil olam haba hi tova, sheba na'asa lo kaparat avonot yoter mikol yisurin. Ve'od hi midah tova mitzad kiyum ha'olam asher kayam al gemilut chasidim ve'chasadim. Ve'em lo yesh aniyut, em mi ya'asu gemilut chasadim. Inami ayri ba'aniyut she'en matzui lo lazun atzmo b'nei beto. ורוב הימים רעבים גם צמאים. That's there. וכאן הייתי ויש לו פרנסה בסמסום ומסויה לו. ורק ברווחה לא יש לו, שגם זה נחשב בכלל עניות.
This is they make you עני. לא עני. You're making the money.
ברוך השם יש ישיבות.
ברוך השם, מה צריך לראות ישיבות?
הנה רבנו הארי פירש בעץ חיים, בורא עולם. Right? בשער הזיווגים, פרק ו', שער שר של שכחה נקרא מס. ולכן אמרו רזל, אין עוד דומה ששונה פרקו מאה לשונה מאה ואחד. מס is 100. אמנם הרמז כתב, מיכאל הוא שר התורה, מספרו קא', כמניין י"ק אלוקים. וזה סוד, אין עוד דומה שונה פרקו מאה. תשר של שכחה נקרא פוטה מספר מאה ומיכאל מאה ואחד וייתכן שיש לשר שכחה כמה שמות לפי דברי הרמז להכי קרי לשונה מאה ואחד בשם עובד אלוקים כי יא אלוקים מספר מאה ואחד שהתמתק שם אלוקים בשם יוד קי ושניהם מספר מיכאל כמו שאמר הרמז והנה שני שמות אלה מס ופוטה מספרה מסמס שסופו למסמס ולהתבטל שגובר כוח הזכירה שהוא מאה ואחד הרומז בשם משה רבנו תמלוי משה כזה מם שין שין יודנון היי א' עולה מאה ואחד
שין
מם the mem of mem mem the yudnun of shin
without the
Aleph of the Aleph is 101. לשמו כפול שאמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא משה משה כדי לבטל ממנו שתי שמות של מס ושל פוטה.
וואו.
לכן כפל שמו בתחילה נבואתו בסנה. לכן זכה לקבל כל התורה כולה, גם מה שהתחדש בדורות הבאים. This gets heavier, but we're going to leave it. Says the Gemara, Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya Omer, Eze u me'uvat, what's crooked, lo yuchal etkon, ze aba la'irva ve'olid memena mamzer. Says the Gemara, holid in, lo holid, lo? Only if he had a mamzer, it's me'uvat, lo yachol etkon. Ta'atanya, Rabbi Shimon ben Menasya, the same rabbi, gonev adam, if he steals, if shashi ha'zir, he can give it back. גנבו, שיחזיר גנבו ויתקן. כוזל אדם אפי סטול, אפשר שיחזיר גזלו ויתקן. אבל הבעל אשת איש ועשר לבעלה. If he was with אשת איש, now she's אסור on her husband, נטרד מן העולם והלך לו. He's out of the world, he has nowhere to go. רשי. גונב אדם, גנבה אפשר שיחזיר ויתקן. נטרד מן העולם, אין לו עוד תשובה. לפי שעשה דבר שאין לו רפואה, אז he can't make her back.
No return.
ראו את ההזבן.
That's going to be a problem.
But the valad, the mamzer, it's something else.
It's a difference. No, so you see, you see that you don't need a mamzer to be irreversible. Once he was osir the lady on the husband, it's irreversible.
Okay, but once the finish, but over here, the mamzer...
What do you mean the finish to finish?
One second.
This guy keeps living with his wife. And you get an avera every time.
Yeah. Right. But the mamzer is like much worse. Like
what's the mamzer doing? Maybe the mamzer is a tamin chacham for all you know. Says the Gemara. What's much worse? Either way, the lady gets divorced. Everybody knows. Why is she divorced? Because Yankel was with her.
No, I don't say Yankel. It's Yankel.
Yankel.
Say small.
100. Right? Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai Omer. En Omer. End of the Baraita, Bakiru Gamal. Nobody says, check the Gamal to see if you can bring him as a Korban. Bakiru Hazir, check the Hazir to see. Because he's Tameh from before. Really, Bakiru Gamal is Ishmael. Bakiru Hazir is Esav. Ela Bakiru Taleh is Bnei Israel. So if so, you can't say that the Me'uvat is something that was always crooked. Like Esav, Ela Zeh Tamid Chacham Shepiresh Min HaTorah. Rabbi Yehuda Ben Lakish Omer, Kol Tamid Chacham Shepiresh Min HaTorah, Tamid Chacham that left the Torah, Alav HaKatuv Omer, Ketzipor Nodedet Min Kina, like a bird that flies away from its nest, Ken Ish Noded Bim Komo. So to a person flies away from his place, which is the Torah. Seems like not. En Rashi, En Omer Bakiru Gamal Zeh LeKorban. Kloma Misha Ya Me'uvat Mitchilato En Zeh Me'uvat. El Bakiru Taleh Zeh LeKorban. Shemen Afal Bo Mum Venet Kalkel. Kach Lashon Kilkul Nofel Be'Adam Shaya Tov Mitchila. So that's a separate point. Now we'll come back to our point. So you see that the guy that was Bala Erva Filu, even if he didn't make a Mamzer, it's Me'uvat Lo Yachol Etkon. The Omer, Ma Matzu Avotechem Bi Avel Ki Rahaku Me'alai. Lo Kashya. Kam Be'achoto Penuya, Kam Be'eshetish. If it's his sister or any other Erva, that doesn't become Asur on anybody because you were with her. So then, only until there's a mamzer is it lo yacholot kol. Kam be'eshetish, that he makes her a sur on her husband, even without a mamzer, it's lo yacholot kol. You can never erase it.
So maybe that's what he was saying, where you have a tikkun, you could do teshuvah, because you're with...
Tosfot says you could always do teshuvah. The question is the avon not erasable?
Because she's not, now she doesn't fall as a...
The achoto doesn't become a sur on anybody. But she ain't kendeshet, she does, correct. If you want, I'll tell you. They're both talking about Eshetish. If he raped her, she doesn't become a sur on her husband. So then it's only if there's a mamzer. If she was willing, then she becomes a sur on her husband. They both, when he was raping her. So therefore, even without a mamzer, it's any acholot kon. By Eshet Yisrael is only Asur Beratzon. She's not Asur, you need a Mamzer.
Did he check
a man? Rashi, Beratzon Asara Uva'ala. Be'ones, lo Asara Uva'ala. Fikach Holid, in lo Holid, lo. אשת כהן אפילו באונס אסורה לבעלה בכתובות. Like it says, והיא לא נתפסה. She wasn't held. אסורה הנתפסה, if she was raped, מותרת. She's מותרתה. ואיזו זו אשת ישראל. ומי דכתיב היא, but because it says she has both someone else. Havelomar amiuta. Havelomar yesh lecha achere. There's another one. Shafopish in it fesa asura ve'ezu zu eshet kohen.
But now the guy is not there. But Ayat Kohen that he saw that this guy is coming.
Is that a chavod eshet kohen rabbi?
Yeah, for sure.
You have to divorce him. Am I doing it?
Absolutely.
Wow. Nice to be Kohen.
Okay. Let's start tomorrow.